Hey, what's up? Here are three things that I've heard Ronnie Wood play in Beast of Burden, live versions, bootlegs down through the years. And he's such a great soul and R&B player. So I've assimilated this stuff. I felt it worthwhile to either listen to it and learn it or just absorb it. And lick one. So Keith's playing the static part. Right? And Ronnie plays this. And I say, whoa. I guess that's under the heading of the ancient art of weaving. Oh, and when they make it work, God. But what a nice counter melody. And maybe some of you are familiar with all the bootlegs, and God knows there's a ton of them. Maybe you've heard that part. But that is right? So that's lick one. Then I hear him do this on another one. So this will be lick two, where in the sequence, by the way, let me just backtrack a second. That sequence, as it's presented on some girls, it's from a full-on bar chord shape. It has to be, because the mids and the lows on that intro guitar are just too rich. You need that entire bar chord to get that kind of body. Oh, but, you know, those guys will take it all the way down from a bar chord to a double stop. Anyway, that being said, a chord in that sequence is a C-sharp minor. I mean, you've got a B to a E, to another B, and then the C sharp minor, finishing with the A. Well, what Ronnie Wood does, and he did this on the Some Girls studio version, is he substitutes an F sharp minor, or he plays a F sharp minor over top of Keith's C sharp minor. And that's fine, because all those notes are in E, the song is in the key of E. But he does this to great effect, or to good effect. This is how it sounds. Right? Okay, so that is this. F sharp minor, just those G, B, and E strings, and then the F sharp minor again to the A, and the lick sequence starts again. Yeah. And lick three goes like this. Again, it's Ronnie Wood. Keith's playing the static part, and Ronnie gives you this. And so he's coming off the C sharp minor here, but he's adding this, making a C sharp minor 7. Lick sounds like this. And he's getting the two of the three notes of the A chord, the E and the C sharp. So that is from here, a C sharp minor. Those three notes are a C sharp minor. Adds the little finger here, that makes it a C sharp minor 7, trust me. And then slides it up, it's a double stop. That implies the A. Check it out. Those two notes, the A. All right, so you're dropping that A out of there. Hardly notice it. Just one more time. So amaze your friends. Learn those licks, and then when you jam along with yourself or somebody playing Beast of Burden, you know, you could, well, of course you can. You already know that. I'd like to do more of this kind of stuff. If you're interested, drop me a line. I'm going to do it anyway, but if you have any questions, drop me a line. Thanks for watching. See ya.